Nita pa brief kidogo pa kisa hibe.
Chomo. Eh? Nambe hui.
Okay. Jambo ambalo limetuleta hapa leo, tumekutana hapa na about 10 days ago tumeomba ruhusa kwa tunataka hall ili kujadili mambo ya devolution, mambo ya port, mambo ya SGR. University wakatukubalia, tukalipa pesa 1025. Wakatupa risiti. Ufika jana jioni wakatuita wakatuambia kwamba mkutano umevunjwa kwa sababu kuna security issue, na wakatuambia kwamba wanahofia yale mambo yasijakatokea kama yaliyotokea Garissa University, na student waka rebel wakawa incited. Kwa hivyo wamecancel, sisi tuambia sisi we are not cancelling it, na definitely kutakuwa na consequences and we are determined to take them to court, so they must be ready for that. Kwa hivyo leo tuko hapa, lakini mkutano huu umevunjwa leo, tutaupanga mwingine next week, na tutaendelea kupanga and we are going to discuss about the SGR na ukora. We are going to discuss about the port. We are going to discuss about taking services from Mombasa to other counties for the benefit of other people and the detriment of Mombasa residents. We are going to discuss that, and they cannot stop us. We are not in the 90s during the Moi time. We have a new constitution. We'll enforce it. We'll practice it. We'll enforce it. And we're not going to be intimidated at all. Kwa hivyo nitamweka David Ndii.
Hamjambo. I will speak a little bit about I will speak a little bit about the key issue that has led us convene this initiative. And this is actually quite basic. We have said for many years that the SGR project is not from it has been demonstrated now and accepted by government and written in the government report that this railway cannot service its debts. That's something we said from the outset, even before it was built, that the debt would be paid by the Kenyan taxpayer. And that is what is happening now. Now, the Kenyan taxpayer is paying the debt. The contract between Kenya Railway and Kenya Ports, which is known as a take-or-pay agreement, requires Kenya Ports to give a certain amount of cargo to Kenya Railways so that they can pay the debt. But because it is not possible, if you look at the financials, it is not possible for that railway to pay the debt. So that contract is moot. The government cannot claim and demonstrate to anyone that they are enforcing this take-or-pay contract, which is what is responsible for shifting the port logistics from Mombasa to Nairobi, and from what we can see, the final destination of the port is Naivasha, on private land owned by powerful people in Kenya. Now, the rationale, the public rationale, that this is for purposes of servicing the debt of the railway is untenable. And that being the case, there is no public purpose for enforcing this take-away, take-or-pay contract. It doesn't matter we as the taxpayers of Kenya are paying for that loan very dearly for a project that is not economically viable. There is no reason other than private greed of powerful people to enforce that contract and shift the port logistics from Mombasa to Dry Dock, which are country, whether it is in Nairobi or whether it is in Mombasa. This is state capture. This is the thing we are calling state capture. The state has been captured. There is no public or economic justification, in fact, for building the extension of this railway from Nairobi to Naivasha at the cost of 100.